Hi, I'm making this video in response to my previous video about listening to reference tracks in Cubase. Because somebody asked, how do I get those tracks into Cubase? So this video will be about which reference tracks do you use, where do you then get them, and how do you get them into Cubase. So let's go. So first of all, which reference tracks do I use for my mixes? Well, that depends a bit on the purpose actually. If I'm just concerned with having a sound that's as good as possible, I may just use general reference tracks that give me a reference for the best sound possible. I will link to a Spotify playlist which contain those kinds of reference tracks for me. But sometimes you also have to match a mix to another mix of a band. In that case, it's good to use the other mix as a reference track. And in other cases, a band may provide you with a reference track to give you an idea about what kind of style and what kind of sound they want for their mix. And if they don't provide you with a reference track, you can even just look on their social media and websites to see which bands they compare themselves with, and then find a reference track from that band to sort of get an idea of where to go with a mix, for example. So if you then have an idea for reference tracks, where do you then get them and how do you get them into Cubase? Back to the studio for that. Alright, back in the studio. So once you know which reference tracks you want to use, where do you get them from? Well, one option is to get them from CDs. Remember those? If you have a CD with your reference track, or you can borrow a CD from somebody with a reference track, then you can import them from the CD into Cubase. I'll show that over here. I'm starting this with an empty project, but normally this would be a project in which you have your mix. The CD is in my CD player, in my PC. I'm going File, Import, Audio CD. And you get a dialog with all the CD tracks. Well, I know that I want to import track 7, which is called Carry On. I can listen to track 7. So that I can make sure that I have the correct track. And then if I'm sure that this is the one I want to use as a reference, you click copy. And Cubase starts importing the track from the CD. This takes a while. So in the meantime, you can have a look at the liner notes of the CD, for example. Okay, when it's done importing, you click OK. And the imported CD track will appear in your project. I want to move it to start at the beginning. If you now play your project, you will actually notice something very strange, because this track is playing too fast, it seems. And that's caused by the fact that my project, if you look at my project settings, my project is a 48 kilohertz project. And the CD audio is in 44 kilohertz. So what you need to do to fix that is you need to go to the pool. Over here I have the imported CD track, and you can see over here it's a 44 kilohertz CD track. You can convert the file to 48 kilohertz, which is my sample rate of the project. I even want to replace this file because I have no use for the 44 kilohertz file. Cubase warns me that this cannot be undone because I'm replacing the file. But I'm bold. And if I now go and play the file. Started life at the wrong place. It basically plays at the correct sample rate. So if you cannot get your reference tracks from CD, there's another option to get them as a high quality file by downloading. There are various sites that can be used to actually download high-res music. If you look at my desktop, for example, Cubase is one option. They provide high-res streaming, but they also provide high-res downloads. And another one, which I've used myself, is HD Tracks, which provide a lot of music as high-res downloads. The only downside of this is that you seem to always have to download the full album, and it's rarely possible to download individual tracks. But for example, if you want to download from HD Tracks, you can put this free sampler into your shopping basket, and then you can download all files. And as you can tell here, 2496 files, 2488, they are at a very high standard of audio file quality. Over here you can see that I've downloaded the free high-res sampler pack. And for example, if I wanted to use this first track as a reference file in Cubase, I can just drag and drop it where I want the reference track. Cubase asks me if it needs to copy it to the project folder, to which I say yes, and I also wanted to immediately convert the sample rate, because downloaded track is actually in 96 kHz and my project sample rate is in 48 kHz. So I can say yes. And as you can see now, the downloaded track has been imported into Cubase and can be used for referencing. If we look at the pool again, you can see that the imported track is at the correct sample rate and will play fine in my project. If you don't want to download your reference track, there's also the possibility to record it from a streaming service. That's an option I use quite a lot myself, actually, so I will show you how I do that. First of all, this is the setup that I use for that. So I'm playing a track via Spotify, for which I have a premium subscription, by the way, so I can play the highest quality files from Spotify. If you don't have a premium subscription, then you can only play lower quality files. But I'll show it with a premium subscription. My Spotify output goes into my speaker correction software, which you may or may not have, but I need to deal with it, which I'll show you in a minute. And from there, the audio goes into my audio interface and to my speakers. But now we also want to record this audio back into Cubase. So in order to do that, there are two possibilities. One is to have an external loopback, which basically means that you need to connect a cable from the output of your interface to the input of your interface. And the disadvantage of this is that first the digital audio gets converted to analog, and then the analog audio gets converted back to digital. So there's one DAAD conversion that's not really necessary. However, you can only use the internal loopback if your audio interface allows that. This means that the audio interface must have a setting in its control panel to directly send outputs back to the inputs. I will show you how that works on my interface, but if your interface does not have that, then you must use an external loopback or actually use a third-party application to provide the same functionality. What I want to do in Spotify is I want to record the song Carry On, which is the same song as that we imported from CD. I now want to record it from Spotify. To make sure that that happens at the highest quality, I first need to adjust some settings. So we're going to Edit, Preferences, and over here you can see that my music quality is set to stream at the highest quality that Spotify allows for my subscription. I also want to make sure that normalization is turned off, so that Spotify doesn't turn down the track. Another thing that I want to make sure of is that my volume in Spotify is set to the absolute max, so that I get the track as close to the original as possible. Now from Spotify, my track is going to my speaker correction software. Obviously, I do not want my speaker corrected EQ curve to be part of what I'm recording, so I need to turn this off. Now I also want to make sure that my SonarWorks application doesn't turn down the gain. So I want to set the gain to 0, and I want to completely disable the speaker profile. Now I need to set up in my sound card, which is by RME. that the outputs are directly sent back to the inputs. For that, I need to open the settings of my main out and enable the loopback functionality. This makes sure that everything that is sent to my main outs is also routed to the inputs again, which are set up in Cubase to record. So I've created a track in Cubase called Spotify. As you can see here, the inputs is my regular stereo in bus. And in the audio connections, you can see that stereo in is set up as the inputs 1 and 2 of my audio interface. So what I now need to do is start recording on Cubase and start playback on Spotify.
Started life at the wrong place, stuck inside.
And as you can see here, I now have a reference track that I can play back in Cubase.
This is my life, I'm carrying on, and I'm carrying, and I'm...
So now that we have the track recorded into Cubase, you may ask yourself, but what's the quality of this recorded track? Well, let's have a listen.
This is my life, I'm carrying on, and I'm carrying, and I'm carrying on. This is my time, I'm carrying on. This is my...
So, to my ears, the differences are very small and I really have to make an effort to hear them. We can do another comparison by looking at the spectral EQ differences in Cubase.
This is my life, and I'm carrying on, and I'm carrying, and I'm carrying on. This is my time, I'm carrying on.
So if you now look at the differences, it's probably even hard to see, but there are two spectrum curves in here. The blue one is from the CD track, and the orange one is from the Spotify track. And over here you see small bits of orange where there are some deviations, but on average, on the part of the track that I played, the spectrum is pretty much the same. So summarizing for me, I think reference tracks which are recorded this way are very usable.
Thanks a lot for watching. If you like this video, please give it a thumbs up, subscribe to my channel, and ring the little bell icon so you get notified when I post another video. See you soon.
This is my life, and I'm carrying on, and I'm carrying